checks that those go through the legal process have had. And illegal immigration is a huge cost to the United States of America. No hospital can deny health care on an emergency basis to anyone. If they do, even if they're in the country illegally, they can sue. And hospitals don't want to get in that quagmire. And I can understand.
That what?
Quagmire.
And then they can go to the education system. And most school systems are not going to wade through the immigration status of those that come in. And in Virginia, and I disagree with the superintendent of public instruction there, he says that his interpretation of a court case is that we can't ask anything about immigration status.
Nothing.
My view is that you should be able to ask every student. I had to produce one for my daughter when she went to the Franklin County Public School, a birth certificate.
Woo!
That is what I think that's a fair request. You produce a birth certificate, verify an age, then you get to come. I had to do that for my daughter, and I think everybody should have to produce a naturalized citizenship certificate, a birth certificate, or a valid residency card. At the national level, in 2007, the Senate Amnesty Program said, even if you come in illegally, we're going to let you stay. We're going to put you on this glide path that we've got.
We like it here, right?
And I think that's the wrong approach. Amnesty will only encourage more illegal immigration. In 1986, when Ronald Reagan was president, the House and the Senate passed an amnesty bill. He signed it. And they said that's going to take care of the problem. It didn't take care of the problem. And when you have an amnesty, and I am fearful that the current administration and most of the Democrats and some of the Republicans in the House and the Senate are going to jump on the bandwagon that Grassroots America stopped
in
2007. And I hope if that proposal comes forward again in 2009 or 2010, the American people will rise up and say, no to your organization and no to amnesty.
Come on, Red, we will rise up.
Nothing fails like home.
Other aspect of immigration is legal immigration. We have one of the most liberal legal immigration systems in the country. There are a number of valid visas. Some of them, I think, undercut the American worker. I know some H-2Bs and H-1Bs. In times when you have economic downturn, that undercuts the American worker, in my opinion. I think you've also got to evaluate what we call the anchor baby policy. In Mexico, if you have a child in a hospital in that country, you have to pay a small fee. In the United States,